Hi everyone, this is Nick. We just made this really nice United States heat map inside of Excel using values with our states, with our state values, and then our visitor values. So the number of visitors that come from each state or the number of customers that come from each state, whatever your audience may be. Now, what if I wanted to just isolate a few of these states on the map? Now, I could do that by sorting my list, and I want to show you one way that we might do that. The first thing that we need to do is we need to create a dynamic table, an Excel table with our states and visitor values. Now to do that, you don't have to do anything fancy. Here's a little shortcut for you, Control T. Just put your cursor in the cell at the upper left and the top value. Excel is gonna be smart and it's gonna say, it looks like we just have this number of rows and this number of columns to make a dynamic table. So all we need to do is push Control T, and you're gonna see, it's gonna say, is this that little sort of ghost range there of those dotted lines? This is the range that we wanna make our table. And I'm gonna say yes, and I also am gonna keep this little box that says my table has headers, because I do have headers, and so I want those to be treated as headers in the table. So let's go ahead and click okay. Now you're gonna get that sort of banded row treatment on the table there. If you are in a dynamic table, you'll know that because this table design tab will automatically pop up on your ribbon. Now here, you can go ahead and choose from some of these sort of standard table styles or colors. So you can go ahead and change all those colors as you wish. I kind of like this just nice normal black headers and sort of gray banded rows right there. So we're gonna keep that one. You also get these data filters. Now, if you get the data filters and you go ahead and click on that little button, you'll see all the different states there, and that's where you could filter out states one by one if you wanted to. Now, if you want to get rid of those filters, you can go to the data tab right here and unselect the little filter button. If I unselect that, now the table cannot be sorted in that way. So let's go ahead and just reselect that, because we do want to filter, and say I just wanted to say, I want to isolate Colorado, Texas, and Wyoming. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead to my filter. I'm just going to unselect all of them so that nothing is selected. And then I'm going to say, okay, I want Colorado. Let's see, Colorado there. And then let's scroll down to, did I say Texas maybe? Let's see, there's Texas and there is Wyoming right here. So I'm going to click okay and see what happens. Yikes. Okay, so my map got really, really tiny. Why did that happen? Well, it's because I forgot to set the properties, the setting properties, the dimension properties on my table. So right now, my map is sort of glued into my spreadsheet. When I sort rows and columns and either hide rows or columns or minimize them like I did in this table, that's going to automatically squish the map as well. We can just make this map standardized so that when I sort the table, it doesn't do anything to the map. So let's actually just go right click on my map. I'm going to say format chart area. This format chart area pane pops up. We're going to go to the size and position icon right there, and then we have to click on this little properties drop down menu. Now you can see right here, it's automatically set to move and size with cells. So that means whenever I move or size my cells, that's the map is going to follow suit. The map is going to be squished or enlarged, something like that, as those go. So what I'm going to do is say move, but do not size with cells. So if I wanted to add extra cells here, maybe I want this table to move along with the map, or the map to move along with the table, but I don't want it to be sized. So I'm going to say move, but don't size with cells. And now I'm going to unclick that right here. And actually, what I think I just did there is I probably squished it to this exact dimension. We don't want to do that. Let me undo that. We're going to rewind that just a little bit. So I'm going to go back to my size and properties, and I'm going to put it back to the move and size with cells. Let's go back to my full states. Let's select all of them so that the map gets just the nice size that we want, this full size map right there. Okay, here we go. Now we're gonna go back to my format chart area, and I'm gonna say move, but do not size with cells. Now, when I go back to my table and sort, let's see, this time I'm gonna do Alaska, Alabama, Arkansas. And we're gonna say perfect. Now my map stays exactly where it needed to be, but my table was sorted. Okay, this is part number two, and this is a much more pro tip for making a map like this. We're gonna insert a slicer. Now you need to insert a slicer from a dynamic table. That's what we did in our first part of this video. I'm gonna go ahead and select all of them so that everything is selected right here. To insert a slicer, you're going to just click anywhere inside of your dynamic table. Remember, you know it's a dynamic table because this table design tab is popped up right here. Now what we're gonna do is go to the insert tab, and I'm gonna go over here to this filters menu right here. We're gonna click on slicer, and I'm gonna click on slicer, and then you see, okay, in my table, I have these two fields, states and visitors. Which one do you want to be the slicer, or which one do you want to filter by? And I'm gonna select state. So once we do that, I'm gonna click okay. And now we get this little drop-down list. It's actually kind of a clickable list of states that you can go ahead and just play with and format. If you make it bigger, you can actually go up here to the slicer menu and you can go ahead and say, let's see, you can play with the column height, the width. You can also, there is a way, let's see, that you can make the number of columns too. So right now we have number of columns one, maybe I want three columns. I'm gonna say three columns, and now you have all of your states right here in this really nice little drop-down list. And now if I were to click one, it will just give me that state right there. If I click Indiana, it gives me Indiana. Let's go to my favorite, my hometown, Michigan, right there, perfect. New Jersey, if I click those, great. Now, if you go up here to this little icon right here, this little multi-select, if I select that, then I can now select more than one at a time. So we'll do Massachusetts there, and then you can see my map gets bigger, but the values are only isolated to those states that we have in here. So this is a really pro tip that you can make some pretty cool interactive kind of dashboard style maps, United States maps, with your visitor or your customer data when you have all those states listed in the row, and then all the customers or visitors that you have in that other column right there. So those two, that two column layout right there. So let me know how this goes in the comments below. It's pretty cool to be able to go ahead and putting these slicers in these maps, a really pro tip that I think you'll like. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design. Don't forget to hit the join button too. $1.99 membership really supports my channel and I appreciate it. Cancel anytime, but you get early access to all these tutorials, some members only content, and also some download codes every time I post maybe a template or a workbook download that you can follow along with. So thanks again for watching. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.